On this week's episode of Liberia.com, I am taking you on an inside tour of the National Museum of Liberia. We will be joined by a guide straight from the museum to carry us floor by floor, showing us where Liberia has come from. So I'm here with Colleen, who works here at the museum. Thank you so much for having us. You're going to be our tour guide today. All right, so tell us a little bit about how this came about. What started this?
In your first place, I want to welcome the National Museum.
Thank you.
We're so proud to see guests like you. So, that we're joining the museum. The museum is divided into three sections. The section right now, we have the three items.
Okay.
If you go on the farm, you want to cook. This is our food.
So this is a traditional country kitchen in Liberia. How it would look?
Traditional country kitchen.
So tell us all the elements in here now.
Yeah. This is the dryer. The dryer. See the stone here. This stone was used more than 75 years ago for our people to find pepper.
So they would grind the pepper to make pepper sauce.
Yes.
All this wrap.
It's a drum that was used by our forefathers for the establishment of communication. Like cell phone, land phone. Why our people used to use it? It is to make the weather place, position in the center of the town. Why they used to use it? It is to keep a person in the town, to guard the town. In case of any man, this is a situation. Person in the town. Put Lala on his drum, beat the drum. You beat the drum, you send all the message to him. What happens? Happiness? What happens? Imagine the situation where everybody may have to come to town. Rest situation, the beat of the drum is set on the
beat. So there's a code in the beating of the drum.
Yes.
Everyone in the village knows that if it's bum bum bum, that's happy because da 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 is danger. So
that's right.
That is amazing.
That's right.
So now we've made it to the historical floor in the museum. And we're starting here at the ethnic bowl. I talked about all of the different tribes in Liberia. So tell the people who may not know, how many tribes do we have in Liberia?
We have 16 tribes here.
16?
16.
Wow. Leslie, can you name them without looking? Let's go.
Loma, Isi, Mayungu, Udi, Bola, Asa, Kan, Sapo, Bele. Bele.
I mean, each ethnic tribe has their own mask that represents their area or their tribe.
Yeah, tribe. Each tribe has their own mask that represents their tribe. And also represent the society and culture. Thank you, all set as specimen. During the second training of this Dali material was donated to the Queen Imperial.
And it looks very royal. The color, the red and the brunish, is always a sign of royalty. And it's original, so we've been able to keep this since 1848 when this table was donated. And it still needs great condition. So you can come here on a lunch break and you can always come here.
Personally, we are speaking of the current currency, the past and current currency. The currency that we use, big grandfathers before the coming of this three slave vaccine.
Okay. This seems to be the first Liberian currency.
This was a form of currency.
Yeah,
one of
this
the first.
The first. If you look up there, you see this is how they should French for it.
Okay.
Wow. Now let me ask you a question going back to the traditional. What are they called? These long.
It's called a kissy pennant.
Kissy pennant.
Yeah.
Okay. So how much would each cost, and was it different lengths determine the different costs?
Like I said, if you see. Up there, you can see some short, some long. The length of the currency determines the value.
Okay. Ah, that makes sense. Okay, so the third floor, the contemporary art, is current Liberian artists, like people that you would see on the street artists, and the museum gives them the opportunity to have a place to showcase their art and sell their art. That is amazing.